Even Andra's not very happy.
He's wasting our time, and his.
So?
The windows were smashed about 4:15 a.m, sir.
Anyone see anything?
Well, the bloke upstairs heard the windows go, car pull away, didn't even get out of bed.
Oh. Well, he better get onto the neighbours then.
Go.
Mr. Nandra.
Your people are pretending this is a burglary?
Well, we start with what we see, Mr. Nandra. A break-in.
The message was clear when the car was set on fire. It still is.
Look, if there's a connection...
My drivers are threatened. A car is burnt and now the new office. But nothing is done.
Mr. Nandra.
I have told you who is behind this. But it doesn't matter. You do nothing.
Enough!
Thanks, mate. Right.
Someone gonna tell us what's going on?
I'm driving along, minding my own business. Wham! He's up my backside.
You did an emergency stop for no reason. You knew I was gonna go
yeah,
back
yeah,
into
Yeah, I do
you.
That
what's
all the time. I get out, he attacks me.
What's he talking about? Listen, he smacked me in the face.
I have a right to defend myself.
Don't talk to me about rights!
Hey. I'll get a breathalyzer on that one.
Right. Let's start at the beginning, shall we?
Action and protection, that's what we ask for, Mr. Conway.
There is already a CID investigation into the burning of the minicab. The possibility of a racial motive.
The certainty. And while you were weighing up the possibilities, what happens to Nandra's office?
I didn't know about the office when I left home this morning, Mr. Rajpal. This is my first call.
Nandra has been threatened. He was told that if he tried to expand his minicab business...
It would have helped if he'd come straight to us with the information.
Why? A car is burned. He tells you the black cabs want to close him down. You tell him how seriously you take it. Now his new premises are gutted.
And we have every intention of finding the persons responsible.
Why don't you just walk outside and hail a cab, Mr. Conway?
He was trying to pick up fares at the tube. That's illegal plying.
A lie. That's a lie! Listen, that fare was booked by my office and I can prove it.
Oh,
you just give him a ring.
And then when I sent you packing, you smashed in the back of my cab, getting your own back, weren't you?
You'll understand.
I'll stick to your own kind.
That minicab on Whitegate's estate last week.
Yeah.
The one that was torched.
The one that was burnt.
Yeah, the one that was burnt. That's my brother's. And I recognise you.
You've got a problem with your eyesight, mate.
We're just mate.
Oh, mate,
yeah.
Me.
Right, that's it. That's it. You're both under arrest. Come on.
The Met asks for cooperation from cabbies all the time, and you get it.
No one is disputing that, Mr.
We got rules and regulations coming out of our ears. The state of our cabs, the hours we work, the fares we pick up, even the way we talk to people. There's always room for us to do something wrong. Room to get a caution, a fine, or lose our licenses.
No more than the law asks.
What's your attitude to minicabs?
We don't have an attitude, Mr. Cadogan. They have laws to obey, and as long as they do.
What laws are those?
The fact that there are different regulations is not our decision. Our job is to implement them.
Do you know how many of my mates have gone bust in the last 2 years?
I understand that, Mr. Cadogan.
Can you understand how many minicab drivers there are sitting outside pubs, clubs, cinemas, stations, working the streets, applying for hire, breaking the law? How many are driving without proper insurance, breaking the law?
And we take action. I can't give you figures for prosecutions.
Okay. Put this next to a list of minicabs operating on your patch. I can walk out of this station and stop a minicab in the street, 2 minutes flat. Our Sunhill Action Group makes representation to the Hackney Carriage Office, but it's at station level things need to happen.
The minority of minicab drivers break the law. The vast majority don't.
Competition's one thing, but it's getting out of hand. It's killing us. Okay, they can undercut us, but they're flouting the law.
I'm picking up his fare, booked by my office, not like he says, right? And this geezer, he drives up and tells me to clear off. I says to him, listen, I'm going about my business. And then he says, do you want your cab torched? I mean, fare's gone, I'm driving away, and I'm thinking to myself, where do I know him from? Where do I know him from? And then I remembered, Whitegate's estate.
We are trying to establish the events which led up to the fight.
Yeah, I'm trying to tell you.
I want to know what happened this morning. Mr. Shelburne says that you were driving dangerously when you went into the back of him.
Look, I told you I couldn't stop. I'm into his boot and he comes out fighting.
So are you saying he hit you first?
I don't know. All I'm trying to tell you is he is one of the guys that set fire to my brother's car last week on Whitegate's estate.
Good morning. I'm Detective Constable Carver, Sonil CID. We're making inquiries into the break-in at the new minicab office, and I wonder...
He had a go, I had a go. It happens. It's up to the insurance now. Well, he did go into the back of me. There's no argument about that.
When you spoke to Mr. Kumar outside the tube...
Yeah, I told him to shove off. Well, he wasn't supposed to be there.
He says you threatened him with the words, "Do you want your cab torched?"
Oh, rubbish.
He also says he saw you running away from the scene of an arson attack on a minicab 6 days ago.
Yeah, well, he's lying. He's out of his tree.
Mr. Kumar has made a very clear allegation, Mr. Shelburne, and under the circumstances, I shall have to caution you again.
Is there any connection between the arson and the break-in, or are they just separate incidents?
Nothing yet. The only connections are the telephone threats, which happened before we got involved. The break-in was malicious and destructive.
Well, the Asian community is seeing all this as racially motivated.
Well, they've probably every right to. But I still need time to sniff the air.
Well, Conway needs to keep things quiet in that area. Is there any help we can give him? Or maybe we should keep an ear open for any help he can give us.
Anything?
Well, I've got four who say they heard the windows go. Only one bothered to get up and have a look. It's unbelievable.
Yeah, I've got a Mrs. McGregor who saw a car driving away.
Well, that's something.
Yeah, dark saloon, and I struggled for that.
Let's see if the Socko's got anything.
When did you arrive at the White Gates estate?
8:30.
35.
And the car was burning?
Yeah.
This man you saw?
Running away.
Was he near the car?
Past the Candy Arms.
Which isn't near?
He'd come from the alley, from Green Lane. He'd come from the car.
What makes you think that?
As soon as I saw the car, I knew why he was running.
That's a bit of an assumption.
I knew. He was scared.
And what did you do?
Well, I saw my brother was all right, and I turned back to look for this.
You didn't find anyone?
No.
And he didn't come back when the place was crawling with police and give us a description. And he didn't contact us later either. It's a bit odd, isn't it? Your brother's car. It's nearly a week now. Tell me, what would you have done if you'd found him?
What I'd done today if I hadn't been stopped.
That's not an answer to violence, Mr. Kumar. Now, if you'd come back to us and given us a description...
Come on! We all know who's behind this. We all know it's the black taxis and we all know how thick they are with you. So what's the point?
And you've no doubt whatsoever that it was Mr. Shelburne you saw last night?
No.
That's all. If the custody sergeant's finished with Mr. Kumar, so are we. Well, we'll need to talk to you again. Wheeling Shelburne.
Mr. Kumar is adamant he saw you running away from the White Gates estate last Tuesday, the 24th. Now, why?
I wasn't there. And I still don't see how he's going to save his no-claims bonus saying I was.
Do you know anything about the burning of a minicab at the White Gates estate the same Tuesday?
No. But whoever did it, good for him.
Oh, you approve of burning people's cars, do you?
I'm not weeping. Well, that doesn't mean I did it.
Tell me where you were on the evening of the 24th.
Yeah, I was with some mates having a drink.
Where?
Jerry Buckler's place.
What time did you arrive at Mr. Buckler's?
7:30.
What time did you leave?
10, quarter past, I suppose.
You drove home?
Walked. Well, the cab was in Jerry's garage. Well, that's why we met up. I took it in for a new starter motor.
What time did you get home?
10:30.
Your wife can confirm that.
Unlikely. Well, the cow walked out 6 months ago.
Well, I'm sorry.
Don't be. It's like banging your head against a brick wall. Nice when it stops.
Interview suspended, 10:26.
Our coloured friends have got you lot running around in circles, haven't they?
Sir, could you have a word with Jim Carver?
We're not getting anything from witnesses. It's like the Whitegates estate. No one saw anything. But there could be some forensic if we get a suspect.
Yeah? Well, like what?
Well, they knocked over a tin of blue paint in Nandra's office. They left a couple of footprints, just bits. But the paint was clearly splashed about. It must have left its mark on shoes, trousers, whatever.
Great. That's just what we need. Right, Alan, when you're ready.
Sir?
Interview resumed. 10:28. Present as before. Right. Can you tell us where you were last night?
Oh, what now? What happened to the 24th?
Just answer the questions.
I was at Jerry's again. Yeah, we had a bit of a session. I had a hangover to prove it. Should have brought it with me.
So you were at Jerry Buckler's house?
Yeah.
What time did you get there?
After the pub, midnight till 4:30.
Was anyone else there?
Mates.
The same mates that were with you on the 24th?
A couple. So? Haven't you got any mates?
Let's just get this right, shall we? While you and your mates were having a party, somebody broke in and wrecked the offices of Mahill Cars.
I heard.
And the week before, as you and your mates were tucking into the beer and Twiglets, somebody set light to one of Nandra's cars. Is that what you expect me to believe?
There's going to be chaos Monday night through till Wednesday. They'll never get Bridge Street resurfaced by then.
And they say they will.
Well, extra bodies for traffic. And minicabs, they could do with a kick. Plying for hire, pushing their luck. You know the spots. We're not looking for prosecution, just vehicle checks, license, insurance. Warn them to keep to the rules.
Could be provocative at the moment, sir.
What?
A CID are investigating some attacks on Asian minicab firms. It looks like there's a racial element to it. And I think Mr. Conway would be concerned about anything that was likely to raise the temperature.
Well, I suppose you'd better hold off for the time being. We'll be asking the community liaison officer if we're allowed to direct traffic before long.
We're still making progress. 3 arrests, 3 prosecutions. 1 community service order, 1 probation, 1 very short prison sentence. For people who've had excrement and burning rags pushed through their letterboxes, who've been threatened with knives, who've watched their children being spat at by yobs, I don't know how you'd feel about that. It doesn't fill them with confidence. All they want to do is get out. There are 12 Asian families here now. 18 months ago, there were 40.
We can't do anything without witnesses. That's exactly the problem Inspector Haines has got with this minicab. His men have knocked on every single door on this estate. Violence is invisible here, Mr. Conway. Your officers are tourists.
Look,
this is a very public place. The driver is wandering around looking for an address that doesn't exist. He doesn't see anything. But how many other people saw this minicab being set fire to?
Ask the yobs who are out on the balconies cheering.
Yes, but we do need somewhere to start. Look, if we can't persuade the people of the community to come forward, if we can't get evidence, you and I will be shouting at each other across a table to no effect until the day we retire.
Do you blame us if we don't trust the police, Mr. Conway? No results, no trust.
No trust, no results. Look, you can talk to the Asian families on this estate. We now have 1 witness who may have identified 1 of the men. There have to be more.
I'll take those keys, Mr. Shelburne.
Have a choice, do I?
Look, the powers of search have been explained to you. It's also been explained to you that you need advice from a solicitor or you want a witness like a neighbour.
Yeah, just get on with it, will you? They're all friends of the missus round here.
Oh. Now. Well, can see why you don't want to open these.
You work for the Building Society in your spare time.
Actually, I think I work for the Building Society all the time. You miss a month and they're never off your back, are they?
Yeah, well, it's a long time since it was a month.
Mr. Buckler?
The very man, how can I help you?
DC Carver, Sunil CID. We're hoping you can give us some information about Brian Shelburne.
Lucky it's not a dodgy MOT certificate, eh? Well, come inside. Brian been speeding again, has he?
How long's this place been up for sale?
You want to make an offer?
Well, there's nothing like trying to impress would-be buyers. When you're finished in here, Alan, take a look outside.
Hey, Gov.
Right. Dirty laundry, where'd you keep it?
You what?
Bathroom, bedroom?
Where it drops.
We'll take a look upstairs. Oh. Is this your daughter?
That's right.
No chance of sorting things out with your wife, no?
No chance at all.
Yeah, thank God it wasn't a breathalyzer. He had a right skimful last night. I told him not to take the cab out until he got it all out of his system.
Did you see Mr. Shelburne on the night of the 24th, last week?
Was that Wednesday? No, Tuesday, that's right, yeah. No, he brought the cab in and we went down the Admiral for a jar and then went back to my place, a few cans and a curry.
Was there anybody else with you?
Only old Mike and Keith again. Sound like four Alkies, don't we?
Flying for hire, Derek.
Eh?
Minicabs. Inspector Monroe seems to think a few fines and prosecutions are going to have our Asian brethren on the street, is that right?
I'm not with you.
We've had some lobbying from the Black Cab Drivers Action Group. Minicabs pushing their luck, you know? So Mr. Brownlow and I thought it would be a good idea to remind them of what the rules are. Dan Monroe tells me it's all a bit too sensitive.
Well, Andrew Monroe is absolutely right. Do you know about this case?
I didn't know it turned minicabs into a no-go area. If we can't get on with run-of-the-mill policing without having to consult the community liaison officer...
It's good to see Andrew Monroe on the ball, isn't it?
I don't find it contributes to the efficient running of this station when my officers know more about policy than I do, or Mr. Brownlow. Before we solve the problems of the nation, a little internal liaison wouldn't go amiss.
You're absolutely right, Philip. I'm glad to see you come round to my way of thinking.
Can I close the door?
In a moment, Mr. Shaw.
I told you, you're wasting your time.
In here, Gov. Look at this. Stuffed inside a cardboard box.
Oh dear, oh dear. Are these yours, Mr. Shelburne?
Look, I don't know what you're trying to do. I want to see a solicitor.
Buckler, Dunstan and Mabbott, they all come through, they all corroborate.
And you believe them?
There's no real reason why we shouldn't.
But you don't.
Buckler had it all prepared. A laugh and the joke all in the right place. Not enough surprise.
The other two weren't quite so confident. Their stories sounded too much like Buckler's. Same words.
Any news in the paint?
Yeah, it's turned out to be very popular. It's on special offer all over Sun Hill. So forensics might not be able to be as specific as they thought.
Great. Pearson Lyons are giving White Gates another house to house.
Again.
Conway reckons we might get a better response. Especially from the Asian community. So if you two don't mind, get yourselves down there.
Gov.
And you and I, we'll see what a bit of reflection has done for Brian Shelburne.
Let's see if the honeyed words of our community liaison officer have made them any more willing to talk to us.
Unlikely, I'd say.
Where were you between the hours of 3 and 4 this morning?
I've told you where I was, who I was with. Jerry Buckler's. I was with him at his house.
You see, when Mr. Nando's place was smashed up, a load of blue paint had been chucked all over the place.
Really?
Yes. Now, you were present during a search of your house this morning when some overalls were found in your garage. The legs had been splashed with blue paint. Now, a forensic examination of the paint on the overalls and the paint in Miss Hernandez's office will enable us to make a very accurate comparison.
So there's paint on my overalls. Big deal.
Do you always use Buckler's garage?
Well, he's a mate. Well, anyway, it's his cab.
Oh. Not yours?
I haven't finished paying for it yet.
How much money do you owe on that cab?
Oh, what's that got to do with anything?
Well, I was just wondering. Must be difficult at the moment to pay back a loan. Business is bad.
That's right. Never been worse. I'm bringing in half of what I was 2 years ago. I've got a mortgage I can't pay, a new cab I shouldn't have bought, and no wife except to pay maintenance to. Oh, and I see my kid once a fortnight in the park. Do you know how much it costs to run a black cab these days, eh, do you? Before you even get it out on the street. And no one pays for the years you do on the knowledge.
Yeah. Minicabs have it easy.
That's right. They're sewing us up. Whatever falls on them's fine by me. But I was still having a drink with my mates.
Thank you very much for your help. We'll be in touch.
It's okay.
What do you reckon?
Well, if you gave me that description and put Buckler in an identity parade, I'd recognise him.
Great.
See, they can talk if they want to. They've only got to be told.
Encouraged, I think, Jim, by the prospect of a result.
Sorry, mate, we're closed for lunch.
Jerry Buckler.
Oh, let me guess, Sunhill Police. What's Brian done now, then?
I'm Detective Inspector Harry Haines. I'm arresting you in connection with an arson attack on a car at the Whitegate Estate last Tuesday. You don't have to say anything unless you wish to do so. Anything you say may be given in evidence.
This is a joke, isn't it?
Yeah, if you like. Now, do you mind stepping out of the car?
The duty solicitor should be here in about an hour.
Everything I've had is gone. That's someone's fault.
They shouldn't be over here. Everyone knows that.
Brigade just arriving. We're on the scene. Give you an update as soon as possible.
Bad news about the taxi wars, Derek. Thought you must have heard. Here to the community ground?
Yes, Philip.
Black cab burning in Askell Road. Looks like a tit for tat. Just when you thought it was safe to go back in the water.
Tit for tat is how the lads in the canteen are seeing it.
Which makes them no better than the idiots who took the law into their own hands. Didn't they realise there were children about?
We're bringing Coomer and his brother in for torching the taxi.
So we're going to be facing another wall of silence.
And even harder to break through this time. So the Asian community got the result they wanted. Shelburne and his mates will be going down for the cab and for trash in the office.
These cab drivers. You've only got to go back to the 60s to realise they were quite capable of knocking seven bells out of each other before anybody thought of a racial angle.
The age of innocence.